Hi everyone, Grant K here for the Smoke Learning Channel. In the previous video, we used Action to create a shadow and render passes. These passes were then composited together, and we finished off by adding a bit of blur and regrain. In this video, we finish off our compositing example by cutting out the foreground objects and recomposing back onto the composited shot. So have a close look at the composite on frame 1. You can see that the 3D object is over the chair, and at some point it'll be over the side table. So let's use the tools in the modular keyer to isolate the chair and table. In Connect Effects, we are using a dual view split, and I have switched to the Connect Effects node bin. Press M to highlight the modular keyer node. Drag out the node and place it above the action node in the schematic. Connect all three inputs into the modular keyer node using the original source. You will need all three inputs to make the modular keyer function correctly. Double-click on the modular keyer node and click the Edit button. So we are now working with the flow graph inside the modular keyer. We will use the master keyer configuration to isolate the chair and table. Change the view layout to a dual view split, or press Option 2. We'll start off working on the chair with the master keyer. Double-click on the master keyer node for its controls. Click the color pot for the color picker. Now click and sample the chair color to start the key. The chair will turn gray because auto color suppression is on. Turn the suppression off as we need the original colors. At this point, we are more interested in the alpha channel. Select the result view and press F4 to toggle to the matte output of the master keyer. So we have a basic outline of the chair, but it needs a bit more cleaning up. Click on the chair to bring up the on-screen sliders. Start adjusting the sliders to keep the chair's edge and achieve a semi-decent alpha. Now let's see if we can remove some of the gray areas on the table. Let's use a master keyer patch. Change the sampling pull-down menu to patch 1 or press Shift 1. Move the cursor over the table. Hold Ctrl Shift and drag a box selection over the table. The patch guesses the filling color to this area of the sample. For patch 1, ensure the color is set to black. Now you can adjust the patch's range and softness to your liking. If you want to, you can also sample the chair with the patch to remove any trouble spots. Now let's use some of the other tools to refine the edge further. Skip the 2D histogram node and select the matte edge node. The result view goes gray because it does not have a matte input. So just select the result view and press F4 to toggle back to the result output. Now let's refine this matte. Enable shrink and set the shrink value to 1. Let's also blur the matte slightly. Set the width to 1. So this matte will be sufficient for our needs. However, we only need this portion by the chair and table. So let's do a quick mask. Select the G-Mask node. Click the result view to bring up the Add button. Click the Add button to start a new G-Mask shape. Draw a rough shape around the area we need to protect in the shot. We want to preserve the inside of the G-Mask and not the outside. Click the Outside button to do this. The last consideration is the color of the matte. White is opaque and black is transparent. So the colors in this matte are incorrect because we want the chair and table to be opaque and everything else to be transparent. Not a problem. Click the Effects Node button for the Modular Keyer node bin. Hover over the nodes and press N for negative. Drag the node out and press Option to drop it into the connection after the G-Mask node. Now the matte is correct. This result is being fed into the Modular Keyer result node, and this will be accessible in Connect Effects. Click Return to exit the Modular Keyer back to Connect Effects. Now let's composite the chair and table over the main VFX shot. Click the Effects Node button for the Connect Effects node bin. Drag out a comp node and place it after the modular keyer node. Take a fill output from the original background shot and connect it into the first red input of the comp node. This means we will use the original image as the fill channel. Next, take the blue matte output from the modular Kia node and connect it into the first blue input of the comp node. This means that we take the alpha we created in the modular Kia and use that to cut out the chair and table from the original shot. If you need to, hold Ctrl Command and pan the ConnectFX schematic so that you can see the comp node as well as the regrain node. Drag the comp node and place it slightly in front of the regrain node. You need to composite the cutout of the chair and table over the result of the regrain node. So drag the output of the regrain node and connect it into the second red input of the comp node. Toggling between the comp node and the regrain node, you should see the difference when we add the elements on top of the 3D model. This is one of many compositing techniques you can use to bring back detail into the foreground. The composite is pretty much complete. And as I mentioned in a previous video, you could do a bit of color correction, but for now, this is fine. Just remember to grab your CFX output node and connect it with the final result for output. Exit ConnectFX to return back to the sequence. Select the CFX segment and press the render button. 3D tracking is not an exact science. Loads of applications use a variety of algorithms to analyze a scene and perform 3D tracking. So results will vary between applications. Some things will work and others won't. But hopefully I've given you the grounding concepts and workflow to enable you to take on the majority of 3D tracking tasks in Autodesk Smoke. With the render complete, press Ctrl Escape to bring up the full screen player. Press play to see your final result. I hope you've enjoyed the series on 3D tracking in Autodesk Smoke. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.